If you guys ever wanted to know if there was a psychopathic clown that's as terrifying as Sweetooth from Twisted Metal, here is that clown.
What's that about clown business?
Do I stutter, bitch? Are we here? We are playing on a level that most will never see. You're gonna start the killing. You best start it right here.
Hello, We Love Film and YouTube. It is I, Austin Putnam, and for the We Love Film Horror Film Project, I have decided to review Rob Zombie's The Devil's Rejects. The Devil's Rejects is the sequel to House of a Thousand Corpses, and it takes place just about a few years after, so, and the Fireflies are now known as the most terrifying killers in the United States. They're known with rape, torture, violence, all of the stuff that you would expect to hear from a serial killer, but just a little bit more. Now the Fireflies are on the run, a new cop, Sheriff Quincy Wydell, played by William Forsythe, who is now up against the Fireflies because they killed his brother in House of a Thousand Corpses. The main two who escape are Baby Firefly, played by Sherry Moon Zombie, and Otis Driftwood. Can't remember the guy's name, but I'll put it right up there somewhere. Their father, Captain Spaulding, played by Sid Haig, who is the father of the entire gang, and he is one of the most psychopathic clowns you'll ever see in a film, no doubt. I am a huge Rob Zombie fan. I love all of his movies, with the exception of The Haunted World of El Superbista, because that was just weird. I loved House of a Thousand Corpses. I love Devil's Rejects even more. I thought his Halloween remake was really well done. I'm one of the few people who liked it, and I have some of a fondness for Halloween too, even though it wasn't as good. When it comes to Rob Zombie, you have to expect his films to be just, the look of him to be sick, twisted, and very demented, and he really accomplishes this look of the film, especially in the hotel torture scene. Now, the characters themselves, the Fireflies, if you ever thought that you would never see the definition of a bunch of sick f***s, this is that definition right there. What they do is pretty much defines the term of sick f***s, and I'm not even kidding. I love the acting in this film, especially from the three main leads. The guy who plays Otis, Sherry Moon Zombie for Baby Firefly, Sid Haig for Captain Spaulding, as well as William Forsythe, who plays the sheriff. They all do their excellent jobs. Otis does a great job of being the more violent out of the group. Baby has more of the seductive angel type look, but once you get on her bad side, she is the psychopathic badass. And Sid Haig does that great job of just being that psychopathic clown that will scare you shitless. If you want to see how scary he is, watch this.
Don't we make you laugh? Aren't we fucking funny? You best come up with an answer, because I'm going to come back here and check on you and your mama. If you ain't got a reason why you hate clowns, I'm gonna kill your whole fucking family.
Yeah, he threatens a little kid, that's messed up. Sheriff Wydell, there's something that happens to his character. One of the things I really loved about this movie was the soundtrack. Now, Rob Zombie is known for his music, but what I really loved was how we decided to go with a more southern soundtrack to create the mood and the tone for the film, because the soundtrack is just simply awesome. At the beginning you have Silver Dollar playing out, and at the end you have no sound except for Lynyrd Skynyrd's Freebird, which was a perfect choice, I believe, to end the film. The film is very violent. This is not for the faint of heart at all. This is a sick and demented film. One of the things I loved about this movie, how in near the end, how the film is able to get you to somehow switch rooting for one character and switch your rooting for characters that you're supposed to not like at all. And how the film does this is a great job. I'm not gonna go into it, but well done. One of the things I have a somewhat problem with this movie is some of the cinematography, because there are some shots where the camera is so out of focus that you can't tell what's going on. But that's really it. Now before I give out my final review score, I have to give a birthday shout out to my good friend Kayla Elliott. It's her birthday today, so yes, happy birthday Kayla. I'm going to give The Devil's Rejects a 4.5 out of 5 stars. It is definitely a great horror thriller film from Rob Zombie. That was my review of The Devil's Rejects. I hope you enjoyed it, and keep a lookout for the next film from the We Live Film Project. And I'll see you guys next time.
Do it. Do it. Do it.